discuss about iterated design pattern theory, principles, real life examples and real time examples. In the next video, we will try to cover iterated design pattern practical implementation using Java. If suppose if you want to buy software design patterns book, you could use the product link which is at the description box of this video. You can just click on that link, you can buy the book on online itself. The book price is very, very cheap. So first we will try to cover the first point: access the elements of a collection object in a sequential manner without any need to know its underlying implement representation. So we can relate this with the real life example. So for example, this is the container. So this is a container. In this container there are various packages, like this is a food package, and then this is the medicine package, and then this is a toys package, and then this is the what can we say, we can say this about glass, which means delegate materials. So here this is a container. This container is moving from Delhi to Chennai. This container is containing these packages: food package, medicine package, and then toys package, glass package. So the this point states is access the elements of a collection object in a sequential manner without knowing to know underlying representation. If suppose if this container needs to be delivered to some person in Chennai, we can relate that person. This is that person. This is the person who has bought this container. Here there is an intermediate person. This is the person. This person will try to unload this container packages, and he will deliver those packages to this person. This is the owner. Owner of this container, and he is the iterator. He is the iterator. He will try to access each package, and he will try to give that package to the owner. So first what you do is you will try to check whether the container is containing something or not. Yes, it contain initially the container is containing food, toys, medicine and glass. So he will try to access the topmost, which means this point, sequential manner. So first he will try to access the glass. So he will try to access the glass, and he will try to deliver that glass to the owner. And then he will try to check whether any other packages are available in container. Yes, food, toys, this package over, food, toys and medicine. He will try to access the next element, which is next package, which is toys. And then he will deliver the toys package to owner. So once again, this iterator person will check whether the package is containing any other items or not. Now the package is containing food and medicine. He will try to access the next package called medicine, and then he delivered that medicine to owner. And then he will try to access the food, and he will deliver that food package to owner. And then he will check whether the container is containing any other packages. The pack, now the container is empty. So this iterator has done his job. So that's the point here: access the elements of the collection object in a sequential manner without any need to know its underlying representation. This owner needs to access these packages, but he don't want to know the internal implementation, which means how to handle those packages. Now what are the ways to handle the packages so that the package won't get damaged? That would be handled by this iterator. So that's his point. And the second point is, collection can be list, set, array, it can be anything. For example, suppose if you consider any programming language, you could say, you could hear this word called collections. That collection is a group of things like set, list, array and etc. So iterator plays a major role. If suppose if you are using, if you know somewhat about programming language called Java, then you could have heard about the iterator in collection package. So here the iterator is a class which is used to access the elements in the collection. And then OOPS. In OOPS, iterator pattern is a design pattern in which an iterator is used to traverse a container and access the container's element. So we have already discussed about this point in using this example. And then abstract the details of traversing the collection. So here this owner don't want to know the implementation details of this package information. So that would be handled by the iterator. That's what this point is stating. Abstract the details of traversing collection. So yeah, the owner has abstracted this iterator handles those difficulties. This owner don't want to know about those difficulties at all. So this is about the iterator design pattern theory principles, real life examples and real time example. In the next video, we will try to cover the iterator design pattern practical implementation using Java. Thanks for watching.